Welcome back! I hope you have managed to solve at least a part of this problem. Then you should consider sharing this idea in the comment section. There's also a question for everyone, so it's worth to check that place out. Anyway, I'm Pawel, I make games, and I'm gonna show you how to create a simple function for changing scenes. Don't forget, we don't use Unity scenes in this example. Showing the new scene is quite easy. We just go to local scenes and grab something what is under the scene number index, and we set it active. Now, to save those changes, we will need something like active scene number. Let's create a new integer called active local scene, and let's give it a value of 0 just to know where we start. Now we set its value to the same as scene number, and that's how we save changes. Copy this line and paste it over here, and instead of the scene number, use active local scene, and instead of setting active, we will set it inactive. Basically, we start with a scene 0, then we disable it, then we go with a new one, and we tell Unity that this is our active scene. Then our active scene is 1, and we change it to something, and we tell Unity that our new active scene is that something, and so on and so on. Now we may just delete this comment, and let's see what we need here. We need to teleport the player. Okay, now we need a public transform, array of transforms, player start positions. Okay, but to teleport the player, which is inside the click manager, first we need to grab the click manager. So let's use find object of type click manager dot player. Teleporting is just changing the value of the position, so let's get this variable. We want it to be the same as player start position, which is an array of transforms, so we need an index, that's our scene number. And we access the position there to paste its value to our player's position. Anyway, let's go back to Unity. First, we need to rename those two objects to be at least a little bit organized. Now we have a blocking canvas and a blocking image. The second one allows us to disable clicking on objects. That's because we have an image component over there and its raycast target is checked. In the code, we're gonna enable and disable this component, but the game object is set inactive, so we won't see any changes. I've lost the part where I show you that, but at the end of this video, you should set this game object active and disable this image component. In the coroutine, we write a simple line of code, blocking image.enabled equals true. Now we copy and paste it, and at the end we use false instead of true. That's because we want the player to be able to play the game again. In Unity, go to the main camera where our game manager is, and use a blocking image as a blocking image there. Now we need our local scenes, there's scene 1, there's scene 2. And the last thing to deal with there is player start positions. So let's create an empty game object and rename it to player start position. Make sure that it is a child object of scene 1. And let's move it somewhere over there. I think it's a good starting position for the player. Now let's duplicate it and move it to the scene 2. And change its name to player start position 2. There the player will start at the left, so let's move it there. And we need to show the Unity where those objects are. Oh, and as we are here, let's click on this. Go to the scene 2 image and get rid of update name tag function there. It would be too much if you had added an additional information to this button. It's clear enough what it does. Now we may click on this button and we have some errors, but we go to the next scene, which is good. the errors appear because we hover our mouse over those two elements and we should show their names, but we don't have any item data to show. For now I'm gonna fix this as fast as possible, and if you would like to, you may do it properly. Go to this big man and let's give him a new item data. And here we will need for now just a name, and I think we may just put it inside those UI images. Now as we go to the scene, we don't get any errors, we'll show those names and we may start fixing this hint message. We don't want to see it here. That's why we will go to this change scene coroutine and update hintbox with null and false. We do this that way because at the beginning of this function we check if our item is null. And if it is, we just hide this hintbox and we exit this function. If you'd like to, I will make an additional video about all the cosmetic stuff we could do here. But first we need to make a game. Now we moonwalk to the next scene and we don't have any errors and it looks quite good. That way we make another step in the process of making this game. Good job everyone! In the next episode we are going to find some bugs and fix them. Maybe we'll also organize our code a bit. For now, have a good day and see you soon!